I'm Randy Pitchford. I'm the president of Gearbox Software. Was a phenomenon, and when we played it, we loved it. I mean, this kind of irreverent character, and through him, we got to save the world, basically. Duke Nukem Forever takes place 12 years after the events of Duke 3D, and in Duke's world, I mean, his world's interesting. It's kind of like our world, but it's kind of like a funhouse mirror reflection of our world. It's not exactly the same, you know? Everything's just a little bit different. Everything's just a little bit stylized or caricatured, you know? Like, so in the real Las Vegas, for example, there is a hotel called the Bellagio Hotel. In Duke Nukem's world, there's a hotel very similar to the Bellagio. Looks similar, it's in a similar place. But in Duke Nukem's world, this hotel is called the Fellatio. And that makes perfect sense in his world, right? So in his world, he is the most important guy in the universe. He has saved the world from the aliens. Well, in Duke Forever, it's been 12 years, and the aliens have come back. And the president of the United States thinks he's going to do a deal with the aliens. The aliens have promised they're coming in peace, and he thinks they're going to do a deal. Of course, Duke knows these aliens are creating a trap. And when they start taking our chicks, when they start taking our women, the Duke's got to step in and do something about this. And so in Duke Nukem Forever, you're going to become Duke Nukem, and you're going to save the motherfucking world. And it's great fun. We're finally going to play Duke. It's been in development forever, and we thought it's going to take forever, but forever comes in 2011. It is here. It's real, and it's coming. This is the Duke Nukem Forever that it's supposed to be. I have been on the outside, just like you, just like all gamers. You know, a lot of people don't know, I actually started my career as a game maker when I moved to Texas to join 3D Realms, and I joined the Duke 3D team. Now, I left 3D Realms in 1997, and since that point, I've just been like everybody else, on the outside, just waiting for Duke Nukem Forever to finally come, because we all wanted a sequel, but it didn't come, and last year, we got bad news that 3D Realms was shutting their doors, and the story was that Duke Nukem was dead, but you know what? You can't kill the Duke, man. And so we got in there and we found a way where we can help Duke survive. And my studio has been very successful. And I was there when we were building the brand. And we have the trust of the publisher, Take-Two. And so we were able to bring everybody together and take a risk and make sure that we can all have, finally have Duke Nukem Forever. It's surreal. I mean, every day it's like, I can't believe it's working out, but it is. I feel privileged and honored that I'm in a spot where I can help. But it's not really me. I mean, it's the team. It's a bunch of intrepid developers at 3D Realms that never gave up. Guys like Alan Blum, who created Duke Nukem, who's been with it since he first created it in 1991 all the way to today. And even when he lost his job that day in May, he didn't give up. And he couldn't give up. And he and his team couldn't give up. And all we did was find a way to help enable them and help his vision and George's vision finally come true. You can't have a Duke Nukem game without a multiplayer game, and multiplayer is great, and it's going to be a big part of Duke Nukem Forever. We're going to be talking about that when we're ready to show it to everyone. Right now, we kind of have to get past the shock and awe of just revealing that this game is back and it exists, and give everybody a taste of it. Then, as we have more time, we'll be able to talk more about multiplayer. It's coming on the Xbox 360, the PlayStation 3, and Windows PC, and it's coming in 2011.
I'm looking for some alien toilet to park my bricks. Who's first?